نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله نشهد ونعقد بأنه بلغ رسالة وعاد الأمانة ونسها أمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين أما بعد قال الله تعالى في كتاب الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتون إلا وأنتم مسلمون واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. My dear respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, respectable elders and beloved listeners, we commence by thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who make it possible for we to meet on a blessed day like this in the blessed house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for grant we the wholesome blessings of this day. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive for shortcomings and wrongdoings. We pray for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family and his companions, and we ask Allah to bless them all. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give we the true followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Part of the message, very messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be delivered to we in order to be successful in this life and Yawm al-Qiyamah, that he inform we of legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inform we of waiting at the best legacy where each and every one of us will ensure that we try as best as we can to leave a beautiful legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why we need to ensure for do this one? Now because there is one thing that is sure in life, that is you and I are going to die. Whether we like it or not, one day, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, another day in this life anymore. And a day will come where you serve another day, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because every day, malaka mouth, they look at you, they let you, and they take another person, subhanallah, via the instruction of Allah. A day will come when the angel of death, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will overlook another person and then he take me. Or you overlook another person and then he take you. And then the one day we will be alive at that particular moment, then we'll say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Then we'll say, certainly and surely indeed, we all will come up from Allah and come to Him. We all shall return because we belong to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make me among the one them. Whenever we left this life, we will leave a good legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, death is a sure one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Innaka mayyit wa innakum mayyitun. You Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are saying to them, you they die, and deserve surely and surely, all of them will die. That is the reality for them. We say we cannot escape death. Subhanallah. Because death, now a death will be all there for pay. We therefore need to prepare for the collector. Because it will come sooner or later. May Almighty Allah grant you a good preparation. My beloved brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed me in the Quran. He said, Kullu nafsin za'ikatul maut. Every soul. Will taste the bitterness of death. Subhanallah. Almighty Allah says in the Quran that everything absolutely, whether in existence, will perish. And only Allah alone then will continue to exist by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Huwa hayyun la yamut. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inna li ever living and only ever die. The jinn and we, the mortal man, and all the animals, including the angels, even the angel of death, we all go die. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant we the ability for that we left a good legacy before we left this place by the will of Allah. My beloved brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informing that among the best thing with a human being to left na dunya, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, na three things. These are the best of legacy. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this, and this beautiful narration is reported by Sunan Tirmidhi, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you look at this beautiful book, where compiled the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salam salam, you will see this beautiful hadith reported by Abu Qatada radiallahu anhu. He said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best thing when me go left the dunya, when you go left the dunya, the three things. And once you left this one, inshallah, you don't get a good legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. None of us know the one for pass away, and people start saying bad things about us. Nobody know the one for let in memory be bad, subhanallah, except for person who is extremely bad. And even the bad person sometimes, at that particular juncture, he will wish that people will say good things about him, subhanallah. Why? Because at that moment, he don't see the reality. He don't see the reality. So if you want to come back to dunya, you can't correct a mistake. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, hey, it's not possible again. Once you don't cross over here, there is no way to come back, to come build a legacy. Why? Because I've been not given the opportunity to let you make sure that you build a good legacy before you come over here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make we among the one there. We will ensure that we left a good legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you want to be engaged in goodness, Almighty Allah says in the Quran, when the dying come to them, then they say, لَوْلَا أَخَرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ. Ya Allah, if you grant me small time, grant me half of a second. If I come back to dunya, for a short doqa, and I can give plenty charity, وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ, and I will be among the good doers, among the one them, subhanAllah, when they invest for akhirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they look at this man at this particular point, subhanAllah, he say, وَلَنْ يُؤَخِرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he know they grant a single second, or half of a second, or quarter of it, to any life when in time they reach. For go, subhanAllah, just like Allah, already don't preordain, we go in. We don't get anything for change or for do about it. Rather, than for ensure, say we prepare for the meeting with Allah. By engaging in Dixem, we will continue for being a productive Dixem even after we have left the dunya by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed me in order for put we in preparedness by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we will be in the grave and we will receive good deeds by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are three things there where we will left as a beautiful legacy. Number one, the Prophet alayhi salam salam, he said, وَلَدُ صَالِحَ يَدْعُ لَهُ. A good beginning, a good child, subhanAllah. A good beginning where we make dua for you. After we don't pass away, a good child. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not only say walad, he stopped it. He say waladun saliha. He add the adjective saliha. A good beginning. Because sometimes many people get beginning, but the beginning, they minus the adjective good. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you a good beginning. SubhanAllah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, among the legacy what we left in the dunya, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will there be of benefit for we in the akhirah, now for left a good child, whether male or female, when they make dua for you after we don't pass away. That particular child, whether male or female, will go raise his hands and his hands to Allah. He say, Rabbi rahmahuma kama rabbayani saghira. Oh Allah, sorry for mama and my papa, just like how they be sorry for me when I be small. If you have this child, whilst you are alive, they be happy. Good news to you, you left a good legacy by the will of Allah. If you have five kids, subhanAllah, or 10 plus or minus, none of the knowledge, subhanAllah, where Sabi recite the Quran. None of the knowledge where they fulfill and finally the salah. My dear father, my dear mother, start crying, subhanAllah. Why? Because you are going without a good legacy. Not only for what begin, many times you cry for begin. Say, Ya Allah, grant me begin. If you pray that kind of dua, that particular dua is not appropriate. Say, Allah, grant me a good begin. SubhanAllah. Waladu salihah, a good begin. That is the dua when all the prophet that we pray. When the prophet that we pray to Allah for begin, they say, Oh Allah, bless you with good begin. SubhanAllah. When Ibrahim alayhi salam, he pray for begin, he say, Rabbi, habli min as-salihin. Ya Allah, grant me a good begin, a good child. You don't only say, grant me begin. We've seen some sisters, when they're married for quite a while, and Allah not blessed them with begin, we hear them say, Ya Allah, just bless me with begin. Me, I just want one that is for SubhanAllah. We have also seen some comrades, when they look at the begin, he say, I wish I know SubhanAllah. In this life, a comrade looking begin, he say, Nasik na puna nibeleno. Even the comrade alive, he realize it already, he don't lose this. May Allah forgive me. May Allah grant you good beginning, one will be proud of by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the second legacy. When you live on a dunya, you get a very beautiful legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Sadaqat wal Jariya, a continual charity by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A continual charity in the form of building up the house of Allah, the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether in a wholesale or in a retail by the will of Allah. Meaning, whether you come halfway by giving 10 bags of cement plus or minus by the will of Allah, you do it solely for the pleasure of Allah. If you do this kind of thing for the pleasure of Allah, then you don't become a sadaqah of jariya, a continuous charity by the will of Allah. Or you dig a well solely for the pleasure of Allah. One more the well, if you dig a well for the pleasure of Allah, then you will stand in front of Allah, well pleasing by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make among you one day when you engage in sadaqah of jariya. Or you make a rope for the pleasure of Allah. Not only because you want a symbol like what we do today. So if we see for today now, that the old money maker, will the money maker want a symbol or want a vote? SubhanAllah, Almighty Allah says in the Quran, قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا. Allah says in the Quran, look, when I will let you Allah tell you that people will waste all their efforts, he said that the one they will exert their efforts in the dunya, thinking that they are doing it for the sake of Allah, thinking that they will get reward from Allah. Allah said they don't get reward from me. Why? Because they don't want for me sake, they rather do it for themselves, or they do it for goods. May Allah tell and protect you. May Allah grant you guidance. SubhanAllah. There will not be among the one them when they engage in charity activities them, in order to forget name or fame. My beloved brother, my beloved brother. Fame is given like flame. In the place for a while, you know they last forever. SubhanAllah. Don't run after fame. Run after the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah pleases with you, he will grant you Jannah. No matter how much you try to please people, you never, ever, 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 ever achieve for please human beings. Why? Because human beings, then they look for one mistake for forget the 1 million good work we don't do. Whilst Allah, if they look for one good deed for forgive you 1 million mistakes. SubhanAllah, who is much easier to please? It's Allah. It's Allah. May Almighty Allah grant you guidance. So when we engage in charitable deeds, we need to do it for the pleasure of Allah, whether building a masjid, or for making rope for the pleasure of Allah, or for deep water well by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or for plant a tree solely for the pleasure of Allah. Any bird where it's from that tree in fruit them, or any human being or jinn where benefits from that particular tree, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you get the reward. Ila yawm al-qiyam. SubhanAllah, this Nasadaqah al-Jariya, you build a hospital for the pleasure of Allah, whether single-handedly or you join hands with subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or you build an orphanage for the orphaned, so that they don't go off hand. Subhanallah. Today most of we begin them when an orphaned inside this deen, they don't go off hand. Why? Because we not build orphanage for keep them in hand. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect me. We've heard of young brothers, the way they come, they say, me what is this of me upon Muslim? When Papa died, the Jama'ah not clear about subhanAllah. So he became what? He go off hand. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you strength for engage in the beautiful things that are solely for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You build a tahafiz. We are people and they memorize the Quran by the will of Allah. Whosoever recites a single letter out of that tahafiz by the will of Allah, you will get a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whilst in their life and after when you pass away by the mercy of Allah, this is not a beautiful legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell me the third beautiful legacy. What we for any chance we left by the will of Allah. He said, ilmun yuntafa'u bih. Knowledge were beneficial. Knowledge were beneficial by the will of Allah. When you get a knowledge, then you impact people with that knowledge by the will of Allah. And that knowledge becomes beneficial for them people today. And they say benefit other people out of the benefit when they get from you. As long as that benefit they continue for benefit people, inshallah, that's all the reward they continue for grow for you by the will of Allah. Subhanallah. You get Quran to teach people by the will of Allah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say khayrukum man ta'allama al-Qur'an wa 'allamahu. The best of us are the one who learn the Quran and teach other people. Subhanallah. You get the knowledge with a very beautiful knowledge, share it with others for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If that knowledge benefits them, inshallah, it will become, subhanallah, a benefit for you. May Almighty Allah make we among the one them where you share good knowledge by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One message where you share online by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where other people that benefit from that good message, then you get the reward by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah for make we among the one them where they left a beautiful legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And ask Allah for protect you from the one them where go and left a very ugly and bad legacy. May Allah not put we among them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take we life in his submission by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم واستغفروه إنه كان غفارا. Last but not forgiveness, hope and pray that Allah will forgive me completely. Astaghfirullah. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, wa bihi nasta'in, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah, wa ala ahlihi wa sahbihi ajma'in wa ba'd. My dear respectful brothers and sisters in Islam, respectable elders and beloved listeners, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in family and in companions, and we ask Allah for bless them all. My beloved brothers and sisters, death is a sure one. Every other thing in this life, it's may or may not. It's may or may not. Beside one, that is death. There is no may not. It is going to happen. It's a sure. Subhanallah. We ask Allah to grant you guidance. So my beloved brothers and sisters, if we convince that one day we will left this particular earth, we need to ensure say we left a blueprint by the will of Allah. We're so beautiful that whenever people see us, they will make dua for we by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are people that will have legacy. Whenever people see, they destroy the persistence. May Allah not make we among them. So my beloved brothers and sisters, we need to ask ourselves, which legacy Allah will have? Will I be proud if I pass away now? The pictures the way I don't upload on Facebook, will I be proud if the people left look their pictures the day after I don't go? Subhanallah. That is the question. The reason why they said this, today Shaitan they play with me, Shaitan they propel me so much. They say, look, upload this picture, you look sassy, you look so beautiful, you look so gorgeous. Upload this naked picture, subhanallah. And then when you upload, people start saying, wow, you're beautiful. You follow, subhanallah, the likes and comments. Why is this like and comment in the minus you teach them every day? May Allah make them forgive for mistakes. Go back and check the Facebook, subhanallah. In this dunya now, in their life, you have to feel it for upload the way you want. But a day will come where you go and put some all what you upload, it will never ever be possible. Go and check your page. You want to make your page a wage or a
kid for you. I repeat again. Ask yourself, subhanAllah, you want to make your page, your Facebook page, or your WhatsApp page, whatever page you get, you want to make them a wage, a good one, or a cage where they will get you your own qiyamah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, he says, Inna nahnu nuhyi al-mawta wa naktubu ma qaddamu wa atharahum wa kulla shay'in ahsaynahum fi imamin mubin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, now we resurrect the death. And we record ma qaddamu. Whatever you will send before, we record up. Whatever good deed they send, we record up. Wa atharahum. Whatever you will left behind as a legacy, we also record up. SubhanAllah, you go on collect every second there is bad afar for you. SubhanAllah, because of the bad pictures that were uploaded on your page, go, it's never too late until you are late. You still have the chance now for those synchronize your page by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Scrutinize them and delete those ugly pictures, because a day will come and go say, Ya Laitani, Amy, I wish I had not uploaded this picture. It is there already. And sadly, some of us, we get persuaded so much with nobody no know at all. If you die, you left that page, that is how it's going to remain. SubhanAllah. SubhanAllah. Go back and correct the mistake, you still have the chance. Leave a very good legacy. Each time people go to your page, they say, may Allah bless this brother. May Allah bless this sister. May Allah have mercy upon this sister. You don't need to be a hafiz on Quran for Islamizing your Facebook page or your WhatsApp page. You don't need to be a hafiz on Quran. All you need is for Shia good messages, that's all. There are good messages every day, upload good messages by the will of Allah in his social media page. Ensure that every day you send a good message. Whosoever will click on that message, you get permission. Yawmul Qiyamah, you will grab, you become a spiritual commissioner by collecting spiritual commission by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved consistent, you when you watch me now, subhanAllah, you know exactly how your page look like. I know how my page look like, subhanAllah. Wallahi, my beloved brothers and sisters, Balil insan ala nafsihi basira, every man now watch over himself. You know exactly what you have done, I know what I have done, nobody don't need to tell me exactly what I have done, because Nabi Duan, I know exactly what I have done. SubhanAllah, correct the mistake now. Make your page as a good legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and get in good deeds by the mercy of Allah, so that when you pass away, you go there inside your grave, you will receive good deeds every day. I'll give a clear example. If you are working and you receive salary, and then they retire you, subhanAllah, why they retire you, the salary is still there on, subhanAllah. Every month they say go collect salary. Every month, subhanAllah. That kind of salary is sweet, old salary where you know they work for at all, subhanAllah. Then they pay you. Every month. That is exactly when you retire, subhanAllah, you will find for letting collect good salary by the will of Allah. If you left a bad legacy, you will collect salary, but a bad salary. Every day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man sanna sunnatul hasana. Anybody who starts a good practice, a good thing, firstly, he gets the reward for starting that good thing, and he gets commission from anybody who participates in that good deed, in the opposite, Man sanna sunnatul sayyi'a. Anybody who starts bad thing, you start bad practice, firstly, you get a punishment for starting that bad thing, and you get commission from anybody who can't bring that bad thing, the Ilayah. So it's possible sometimes you repent, but you want the way God by the bad, they don't become five holes, subhanAllah, which is good now. Imagine five holes, they grab you on Qiyamah, they say, Ya Allah, that man we want good jannah. Waqifuhum innahum mas'ulun. Ya Allah, stop that man. He gets a question before answer. Naeem, be indoctrinate me by this sinful activity, whatever. Ya Allah, stop my first part. SubhanAllah. Naeem, teach me this criminal activity and now become a professional in it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make we among the one them when they start bad practices then. Ensure that we start good things so that you can be a good legacy for we by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that whenever people call your name, they will make dua for you by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know the moment somebody die, the moment me die or you die, the angel they come for can listen to what people they say about you. That is record number one. They say, imagine somebody died, and the community say, Alhamdulillah, Ya Allah, tell you when this man died. people thank Allah because he died. SubhanAllah, most of you terrorize the community. You are granted a forgiving. You have a country guidance. If you na our sunnah, and then you die, you turn and they say, Alhamdulillah, ya Allah, tell you, take away this bad life. Most of you na a terrorist, may Allah forgive you, stay safe. But if you pass away, you turn and say, oh, cry, ya Allah, sorry for this, ya Allah, sorry for this, we landlord ya. That shows that you realize that you're not a landlord. SubhanAllah, you serve na tenant. May Allah forgive you. Well, the true landlord is Allah. He owns everything. Let them pray for you, SubhanAllah. Let people around you miss you and they make dua for you. That is a sign of a good legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah for make we among you one them. We invest in goodness so that when we pass away, inshallah, we will have a good legacy by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah for accept a good deed by the will of Allah. Part of being among those who have a good legacy. Now for ensure say we join organizations. We join forum them. Where they promote goodness by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where they promote goodness by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Example of that is a beautiful organization where by the will of Allah, they are the ones that invited me today by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This beautiful organization known as Mido by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A movement where they try to promote Islam by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The brothers are here by the will of Allah. Inshallah. They will tell us exactly how beautiful this organization is. It is upon us as Muslims, young people, for using energy, inshallah, in order to gain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll use the energy when they use in haram and convert that energy to halal by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, Allah will look you up on Qiyamah and he forgive you because of the effort we make by the will of Allah. May Allah make you among the one way they pass away and leave a very good legacy by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Among the one way they pass away and people have missed in terms of goodness by the will of Allah. Among the one way they pass away and people have made dua for them by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Among the one way they initiate good practices there by the will of Allah. So that inshallah, even after we retire, we will receive good deeds by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah bless the Lord. May Allah bless the Imam said. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make me among the true investors that will invest in the investment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah for bless the Lord. We ask Allah for reunite in Jannah of Firdaus. We ask Allah for bless the elders then. We ask Allah for make me among the young ones that will respect the elders then. And among the elders that will sorry for the young ones then. By the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah bless this nation. May Allah fortify this nation. May Allah guide leaders then. May Allah guide them to policies that will lead to the progress of this nation. May Allah protect them from policies that will lead to calamity and chaos. May Allah bless you. May Allah grant you job and pull me inside the king by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those of us who want for married, may Allah grant you good spouse. For those of us who don't marry, may Allah grant you good beginner. By the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah bless you start them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them commission from all the good things them. By the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت واعطنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما اعطيت واقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت انك تكفير بالحق ولا يغلى عليك لا اله الا انت سبحانك انا كنا من الظالمين حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل ولا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العظيم اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين واذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر اعداء الدين اللهم ارفع عنا بلاء والوباء والزنا والزلازل والمحن وصور فتنة ما ظهر منها وما بطن برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد سبحان الله بحمده سبحانك اللهم بحمده نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك واخر دعوانا ان الحمد لله رب العالمين.